The American Hot Rod is as much a celebration of the automobile as it is a testament to the engineering and technical know-how of its builders. Hi, I'm Joe Kelly Jr. This is the Car Room Magazine's Playing with Cars. Now, two rods in particular have always been the benchmark by which those that followed were measured. One was the Little Deuce Coupe, built by the Alexander brothers, and the other one was the Grabowski T, better known as Kookie's car from the television show 77 Sunset Strip. Danbury Mint has modeled them both in 24th scale, and the Deuce has been out for a while. But if you want to see that T, you're going to have to follow me. Come on, let's get kooky. For whatever reason, Fords just seem to make great hot rods, and among the Fords, two in particular, the 1932 Coupe and the Model T, almost single-handedly define the hot rod aesthetic, even if that aesthetic was nothing more than a primered rat put together with whatever the shade tree mechanic could find. But in the right hands, the cars could become legendary. One such machine was a drag car called the Silver Sapphire. Once retired from drag duty and rebuilt as a custom by the Alexander brothers, the car would appear on an album cover for a Beach Boys record and be known from there on in as the Little Deuce Coupe. Danbury's model of the car is nothing short of amazing. Beneath a simulated button-tufted roof, its absolutely flawless paint and piles of chrome bring the car out as a dead-on replica of the Slam Show Rod. Neat little reverse chromed wheels wear wide white wall rubber, and the car's got opening doors and a tilt-up rumble seat hatch. The former reveals a beautifully done tufted interior formed from soft touch vinyl. Those seats feature pin-straight piping and scaled safety belts crisscrossed on their bottoms. The floor has been flocked with a baby blue carpeting, and the dash has been jammed with neat, readable gauges, a scenario that continues above the windshield with this upper row of gauges set into the header. These were a necessary addition that helped the car's owner, Clarence Chili Catallo, keep an eye on the blown old motor up front. Try to keep your eyes off it. It's not going to be easy. One of Danbury's strong suits is their engines, and when one is left out in the open like this one is, it's bound to be impressive. In front of a mirror-polished firewall, the powder blue block and heads wear cubic yards of chrome. The trio of Stromberg 97s is piped and linked in atop a neat GMC blower wearing a real rubber drive belt. My favorite detail is the clear ignition leads. These pulsed blue when the engine was running. It must have been quite a show. The only rumble back here is the sound of fuel sloshing around in this tank. It's a neat metalized piece that sits astride the battery above a flat floor. Swing down past the cool custom bumpers and quad-tipped exhaust for a high wattage frame. The die-cast chassis has been painted silver and the equally shiny floorboards are the backdrop for a chromed exhaust system and suspension. One of the coolest details is the brake lines that follow the steerable, posable front wheels, and the stacked hidden pipe exhaust system is a lesson on custom looks with legal sound levels. The other iconic car from Danbury Mint is Grabowski's T, Kookie's car from 77 Sunset Strip. Kookie, the nickname of Gerald Lloyd Cookson III, played by actor Ed Burns, may have had the hearts of every young woman in his pocket, but one thing he didn't have was the keys to the actual car. Norm Grabowski insisted on driving the car on set after one of his earlier cars had been thoroughly trashed during filming. After spending a little bit of time with the Danbury Mint model, I can understand how Grabowski felt. This was a beautiful car that set the standard for every T to follow. Up front, the chromed axle and steerable posable wheels have been set suicide style in front of the frame rails. This gave the car a drop and a rake that the model follows perfectly. The cut-down radiator shell has been fitted with a photo-etched mesh, and the model's flawless Dodge Royal Lancer blue is accented with tamped-on pinstriping and perfectly replicated flames. These were done in life by Dean Jeffries, and the Danbury team has every lick right where it belongs. Just in front of all that is another masterful open-air engine. This time it's a 52 Cadillac set under a quartet of Stromberg 97s, and it's been impeccably painted and thoroughly wired and piped. Check out the linkage as it runs across this horn manifold and the trick triple dip swirl of the steel oil line as it enters this filter assembly. This is thorough modeling, thoroughly enjoyable and kooky indeed. Back a bit farther is the bucket, a channeled down body from a 1927 T, which replaced the Model A coach work that Grabowski had originally installed. The single opening feature is the door, which was seldom used in filming. Just beyond, there's a flocked floor, a neatly gauged and pinstriped dash, and most remarkably, a scale model of the bloody skull that Grabowski hand-carved and painted as a finishing touch atop the long shift handle. If that's a little spooky, you can install the uptop, a piece that Grabowski built so the TV audience wouldn't recognize him as he drove the car in long-range second-unit motion shots. What none of the viewers got to see was the amazing frame beneath the car. That's okay. Danbury hasn't missed a single detail under here, from the lower radiator tank and accordion cooling hose to the clamps and hangers on the trick hideaway glass pack exhaust. The linkage for the clutch, the fuel lines, and even the lines to the brakes are all here, along with what has to be the best-looking live-axle rear end ever hung under a street rod. I can't remember the last time a pair of models looked so good together. Danbury Mint's Hot Rod series is ever growing, and given the quality and detail of these pieces, that's an easy thing to understand. I want to thank the Danbury Mint crew for sending these cars along to us for review, and I want to thank my partner Brian Schindler for his review of the cars in the Car Room magazine. Well, that's it for this episode of Playing with Cars. For the Car Room magazine, I'm Joe Kelly Jr. Thanks for coming down, and thank you for playing with cars. Take care. Bye-bye.
Okay, then.